remember like hearing about the coronavirus and being like, oh, it's kind of sad that it's happening like in China and Italy and other places. And then like our events got canceled and I was like, oh, like what is going on? I thought it wasn't affecting us.
It's been a massive curveball and I'm not used to it at all. And it's been really hard because there's lots of distractions at home. I'm so used to being in a classroom setting, obviously. But I've been pushing through.
All the seniors were pretty much bummed, but as time went on and we got into like a new routine of things, I did all the online school, online seminary, all those things. We got into a routine. I think it got a lot better for all of us.
And I feel like we missed like a lot of the big moments at the end too, like grad night, prom, graduation, obviously. Just kind of a downer. But I think the cool thing is that like, since we do have like online schooling, we can still like get our stuff done. And the teachers are really like helpful.
Every part of your day is in a schedule, to not having a schedule at all has been kind of it's been a jump.
Well, I didn't anticipate having to go from being in class to seminary to being online. It's definitely not something that anyone can be prepared for.
We've had such high expectations in our final prom, our final spring weeks, all of our assemblies and everything we've kind of been waiting for. So having that kind of taken away at this time, it's been hard.
All this chaos everywhere is like inside the churches, it's still relatively calm. Like we just flipped a switch basically when the virus started and was like, okay, you're doing this now. And
Heavenly Father knew this was coming couple like 6 months beforehand and was able to institute these changes, so we're not flipping the dime on us like right as it's happening. It's we have time to acclimate and get used to a schedule.
We're so used to having like a strict schedule and doing things, and doing seminary or doing classwork at home is a little difficult because there's a lot more distractions than being in a classroom where there's not very many distractions.
It's been more of I have to be willing to wake up instead of like, oh, I have to be at seminary in school. And so instead I get to choose to like wake up. And so it's been a struggle, but it's gonna be a worthwhile struggle.
I think the structure was probably good for me. I feel like my sleep schedule is not very good now. I feel like I've just kind of had not much to do. I've been laying around a lot, but trying to do a little schoolwork here and there to prepare for some AP exams still. But other than that, I'm just preparing for a mission, so I don't have to worry about school stuff too much right now. So
we had the opportunity to have that personal time where we could study by ourselves and take as much time as we needed. It wasn't just like allotted to like one specific hour.
My family relationship has strengthened. I feel like that's strengthened my testimony as well. And just doing sacrament at home, I think that's a really awesome thing. That really strengthens my testimony.
Kind of been a time for me to just take a break, focus on myself, like be in tune with so many things, like spending time with my family and just really getting to be with them at these final moments of my childhood.
With that, I mean, I've spent a lot of time with my family, which has actually made our family grow a lot stronger, which is really nice.
When we started doing the home center church and then this happened and they had to close down like the buildings, it really kind of like made me like, whoa, like Revelation's real, like the prophet knows what he's talking about.
I feel like I've gotten a more personal level with him just because I'm not getting as much taught by people. I'm like trying to teach myself.
And doing the lesson by yourself and just like being alone with the Savior and like, yeah, just praying by yourself. I feel like it makes it more personal.
I had just gotten the Melchizedek priesthood, and that was my, I was able to give her a blessing. So it made me feel a lot closer to Heavenly Father, to feel that blanket of peace and comfort.
So I've done a lot of scripture studying on my own, or even going back and looking at my patriarchal blessing to find certain things.
Going to church and like talking to the guys and making sure we're keeping up with each other. It's definitely been like a one-on-one, and then texting and messaging like through your ward is also helping out. But it's definitely been like, make sure I say my prayers, make sure I read my scriptures, make sure I do that kind of stuff.
Like, I know that God loves me and I know that He has a plan for me, but when you feel in control, you don't really remember that God is controlling, like God is helping you in your life. And so now that I feel really out of control of everything, I have to put trust more in Him, because He's the only one that can really like make things happen.
With us being at home and me being still and being in tune with the Spirit more, that I've grown a closer connection with Heavenly Father.
I just know that my family has been just a gift for me from Heavenly Father, and that's just, it's just something that really strengthened my testimony.
I can have more personal conversations with Him and ask Him the questions that I don't think I would have ever had or had the chance to ask Him.
God obviously knew what was coming, so I think it's just shown me that the church doesn't stop, God doesn't stop, His work will never stop. And we'll just keep going on no matter what happens.
Even to planning on serving a mission, that wasn't something that was on my mind. But with this, I was like, I could totally do this. I can go out and I can just help serve and help bring people to Zion, you know. And but I have super high hopes for the future, and I think this was a really good experience for people to go through.
Preparing for the future this whole year has been super exciting, and it's kind of nerve-wracking. I'm gonna be out in the real world by myself, but I'm so excited. I'm so excited to finally get out there and do what I'm supposed to do in this world and find my purpose.